Okay. Projectile protection. Chain helmet. Food. Efficiency axe. Nothing I need immediately. Nothing else, rather. Oh. I also need a new stack of torches. I'm kind of taking this a little too slowly, I recognize, but... yeah, I believe there's a lot more mob stacking later on in the map. The whole infinite anvil thing is really generous, though. Let's see. Let's follow the track this way. Skeletons despawn. I guess the area unloaded. Let's see. Okay. Why are there so many spiders? Why does it always have to be spiders? Okay, there is definitely something wrong here. There's gotta be a spawner around here. Yeah, this is a big area. Which is another reason I probably shouldn't have decided to take it on first. You know what? I got the early useful resource out of it. I think I'm just gonna call that good. That is, I have the small anvil farm, and I never have to worry about arrows again. Because unlike some other super hostile maps, it's really easy to get between intersections. You'll see. Well, to get back to cleared intersections. Let's check out the other side area, though, where we could see the Everforge from. Alright, I've done some anviling. I have a new set of armor, protection 4 helmet, fire protection, chest plate, blast protection, legs, and feather falling boots. Stack of arrows, I went and grabbed some stone pickaxes and got rid of my wood ones, and I also threw together a smite unbreaking looting 5. Basically an awesome undead sword. And I think we're gonna take on the Everforge. I should probably grab a couple of chests. Because I really need to start setting up, like, chests outside of an area. Just to temporarily stuff loot into. Running low on steak, so having a bunch of loot chests will also be nice. Alright, so the Everforge has been mentioned to have saplings. There's a creeper spawner over here. Well, out there. And this is kind of a throw you into the fire type of area. So I've got my chest there, bricks on my bar. So it really is one of those areas you want to sprint in, light an area up, clear it out, sprint in, light an area up, clear it out, and so on. The reason I'm probably not going to make a Bane of Arthropod sword, just because that only works on silverfish and spiders. Oh, I forgot to restock on torches. Whereas smite swords work on... Let's see, I think there's probably going to be a spawner hidden in here. Especially since there's a torch above that. No? I guess these are supposed to be like bookshelves that are empty. But this is where the saplings are. Oak, of course, being the most useful overall. Let's see. Bottles of enchanting. Food that isn't stew. Lots of steaks. Iron pants. Projectile protection chest plate. Doesn't look like I need anything else in there immediately. Well, what's in on the bow? Flame 2 and Unbreaking. That's going to anvil onto this power bow. I'm saving its durability now. Spawned. Whoa! Spawned over there. Is it underneath one of these things? It's nice to get more furnaces, but must be over here then. Aha! I forgot that there are hidden spawners in this area. And I have particles on low because I'm recording. Maybe I need to turn it up to high. See, nothing's over here, so I can take out this spawner safely. And I need more torches. Because I'm pretty dumb. Hey. I don't remember this. Thought I remembered the first intersection pretty well. oh, this is that thing for Axel Rosie, the person who does, like, Vex's YouTube thumbnails and a lot of art. I'm not gonna lie, I might scum and cheat off screen just to see what it is. I believe she was also one of the beta testers. Okay. So let's fix this inventory. So that should be slightly more expensive because that's putting, yeah. Because that was putting a new enchantment onto a bow. That costs 20 levels, which I'm close enough to that I don't feel bad using the bottles on. Wait, was it 17 or 19? 20. So, neither. I know I'm burning through bottles, but I'm starting to put, like, extraneous supplies in my mob loot chest. Where did I get the, I guess because there are a lot of creeper spawners in there. Bones. Books are over here. How do I have an odd number of slabs? Where'd I get the feather falling boots from? I don't even know the loot I'm picking up anymore. And I'll combine these. Okay. And torches. Almost forgot again. Oh, I actually need to make them now. I should be able to make plenty. That would be 20. I have enough spare food that I feel okay in putting away these mushrooms. Okay. I keep just not thinking, basically. And I should put the pearl away. Getting a surprising amount of ender pearls. Probably should have thrown Unbreaking 3 onto that. Did I get this already? No, I didn't. Rocks lost XP. Life is such a witch. A beta tester lost a full 30 levels to a witch. I think is the story on that one. And that's the thing he built as a result. And I went the wrong way anyway. Okay. Actually, I believe there should have been some loot over there. Behind that wall of furnaces. That's why it's called the Everforge, man. Lots of XP bottles. Golden apple. There's just a handful of items that I will take without question. I have a lot of that anyway. I have a tendency to overtorch. That. I think this was before the zombies horde mechanic was added, so. Don't really need the broken anvils. Ah, skeleton spawner. More skeleton spawners. Thanks, Mr. Skeleton. Is there one in here? God, the door noises are annoying. I guess I'll light up each floor as I go. Guess I'm doing this room. Wait, am I playing on hard? Oh boy. No, don't throw away the steak. Okay, I'm just gonna go up to the next floor. Go from the top down. This seems like a much saner way to do this. Okay. Have a regen potion if I need it. Need to remember that. Don't need the sign, or the broken bow, or the spider eyes, or the string. Up here is an anvil. Yay. Okay. Okay, there's probably a spawner on that roof. Wait, what the? Oh, yeah, that's a witch. I should shoot that. I shouldn't be up here. I need the regen. Oh god, more blazes too. Oh jeez, why? Vex, why? Why is this area? What? I'm going to be sane. Block that off. And block this off. Let's see, which XP bottles? Just gonna pop them now. Sugar, glowstone, sticks. Trying to get that, see if that's just a water bottle or what. These are dead chests. No. Nothing I need in there. I have a stack of bones. Let's pick those up instead, since I have infinite arrows already. Okay. Okay. Bows aren't amazing, but it's better than nothing. That was actually kind of stressful. What's over here? Besides pain, death, and despair, I'm sure. Tears. I thought I remember this area being relatively easy. There's a chest. What's in the chest? Diamond sword with unbreaking and silk touch. Silk touch? I'm not even gonna question it at this point. Just take it. I'll throw another smite book onto it or something. This area is a mood changer for sure. Wait, that witch dropped bread? Stale bread, better than starving. Hey, it's better than stew, or is it the same? I can't remember. But I'll take the XP instead. Oh, that's a night vision potion. Heck yeah, I'll take that. It's a shame it looks exactly like a water bottle, though. Okay, so it's relatively safe to go up there. I'm gonna go down, finish this tower off first. Stephen King's Dark Tower. That's not the right bow. Okay. The real super hostile starts here. Or these arrows. Bones are significantly more important. I don't need these sticks. Power 3, Flame 1. Honestly, I'll just swap it out. It's only on breaking 1. Bow, arrows, whatever. Now I'm super tense. I love night vision, though. There must be some kind of way out of here. Okay, get out of here before you can poison me. Oh, great. Aerial spawners. Because that's what we need. Monsters spawning in spots that can't be lit up because they're air blocks. Why am I wasting my sharpness? Slowness, really? Still need to turn that off. I still need to actually set my spawn right. I have derped 4 times. Is half dead. No way to properly replace it with enchanted gear. See, that's one thing that I don't like but understand based just because it has to be balanced. You need to get to the victory monument before you can really take advantage of having all these anvils, because until then it's just the mercy of what books Vex gives you. Boop. I used to not like the specialized damage enchants, but I really am appreciating them now. If I could get knockback on my Smitey. That'd be pretty good. Whee! Feather falling is fun. Okay, what do I have that's... Okay, everything I have can go in a chest. That goes in the ender chest, that goes in mob drops. Equipment, mob drop, okay. so many bones just from having a looting, unbreaking smite sword. Must be some kind of way out of here. Trump and a dude will leave. Okay. I'm relaxing. Chilling, maxing, and relaxing. Okay. I guess there is a perk to not having night vision, and that's actually being able to see what needs to be lit up. I just like night vision in vanilla because I don't need to light things up too well if I'm only going to be there once, as is the case with most caves. Okay. If it's not already night, I'm just gonna set time night. Because I know I have the chest over. Bed. That's what it is, the bed. Okay. There. Sugar, I guess, goes in with food. I guess night vision is okay. I remember Vex was actually doing like a kind of a stealth mission with invisibility and night vision. It was kind of hilarious and awesome to watch. Okay. Where are the witch spawners? Okay. Bottom floor has been cleared. Ooh! Okay, that's a diamond chest plate. That's fantastic, amazing. Alright, let's clear the rest of this area out. Oh wait, there's a basement, apparently. That's okay. I've survived this much. XP bottles. Don't need extra night visions. Don't need extra arrows or sticks. I'll take those. That. What the? Since when can mobs climb ladders? Probably partly less chaotic because there hasn't been time for anything to really spawn in. Okay. I'll take the bone. Pearl. Water helmet. That? Yeah, I'll take that. Okay. Much better. let's go to the entrance chest, deposit the things we don't need on us. Okay, I don't need apples, pearls, eyes, powder, this armor. Keep that. I keep forgetting to deposit the XP bottles at the ender chest. Okay. Did I check in here? Infinity efficiency pork chop. Psst. Wait. Where are things spawning? Up there, I guess. Was there a floor I didn't clear? Oh, yes, I did. Where did you come from? But the healing potion. And witch feather boots. I mean, it makes sense for a witch to drop a health potion. It's not a drop I usually think about. I'm not even sure if it's a situational drop or... Okay. There's stuff spawning on this roof. There is apparently a spawner just next to the roof. Okay, this is scary. I need to chug this healing potion. Another blaze? What's that? Are these just up here so that you don't do this thing that I'm trying to do? Jeez. Do you think that's enough spawners? It's Vex, there's never enough spawners. Case in point. I guess it has to be in here, really. I'm just gonna pop these. Ugh. Okay. Is a blaze suffocating? Oh, there's a layer down there. Hmm. Oh, that is... What? There's already an opening. Where's my boat? No! The wool. No. No. Okay. I want to let the poison wear off. And the slowness. Oh my god.
Okay.
That's a way to end an area. A room full of witches, blazes, and creepers. Regened a little. One got down there. Okay. I'm gonna try and dig my way down. Okay, this area turned out to be significantly more terrifying than I thought it was. Don't care, I'm on fire. Get out. Are you kidding? Chest back. That sucks. Okay, I really don't need these or those, that or that. What can I? I have plenty. Even though I realize I'm not going to come back here, I need to get rid of these spawners. And somehow this pick is not actually broken. Whatever, we did it. We conquered the Everforge. We caught the magenta wool. Plus 20 stress. Okay. I hope you guys enjoyed my mental torment there. Next time on Inferno Mines, we're gonna go through the outer darkness, a much less stressful area.